was Raymaster Flex here, and you know, last night was WWE's SmackDown's exclusive pay-per-view of Hell in a Cell, and I wanted to do this video right after the pay-per-view happened, but I unfortunately had to go to bed to get ready for school, and now I'm up to get ready for school. And I just want to do a quick video on my reaction to Sami Zayn's heel turn at Hell in a Cell. I think this was well needed in a lot of ways because Sami Zayn's character wasn't really getting anywhere. You could really start to see the tension that Sami Zayn was having throughout the whole thing with Kevin Owens and Shane McMahon. The fact that Shane McMahon tried to basically back him off and tell him, you know, you had your business, I'll handle mine, and was saying that he could deal with Owens on his own. So you start to wonder if the reasoning as to why Sami Zayn attacked, why he actually helped Kevin Owens avoid going through the table at Hell in a Cell was because of the fact that Shane kept ignoring him and making it all about himself. I could see Sami Zayn coming in the ring on Tuesday night on SmackDown Live and using that as his excuse as to why he basically helped Kevin Owens defeat him at Hell in a Cell. It's going to be quite interesting how they book this whole thing. And I don't think at this rate with Sami Zayn turning heel that they should move or trade Kevin Owens back to Monday Night Raw. I think Kevin Owens rightfully belongs on SmackDown Live. And it was just unbelievable what happened at Hell in a Cell. I just couldn't believe the fact that Sami Zayn finally turned heel. I mean, you could see it eventually come. I mean, how much more times are you going to see Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn battle each other over and over and over again? I mean, every match they've had for the most part, especially on pay-per-views, they've delivered. But how many more times do you want to keep seeing these guys battle over again? We know in real life that these guys are best of friends. So it was just quite interesting to see Sami Zayn finally snap and actually help Kevin Owens win and defeat Shane McMahon. I mean, we knew he was going to beat Shane McMahon in some shape or form, some fashion or form. We just didn't know how he was going to beat him. There were already rumors flying around that Sami Zayn was going to enter. There were rumors Triple H was going to come. But in the end, the only person who interfered in the match was Sami Zayn. And that will be in the history books. It will show, you know, that Kevin Owens defeated Shane McMahon, but with the help of Sami Zayn. And, you know, like I said, it started to seem like they were kind of getting somewhere when Sami was teaming up with Ty Dillinger. Like, it seemed like they were going to make them a team. I don't know what happened. And it just kind of put Sami Zayn lost in the shuffle. He wasn't really getting that much opportunities. He was losing every opportunity he got. When he had the opportunity to battle for the United States title, he lost that opportunity. He had an opportunity to battle for the WWE Championship. He lost the opportunity because why not? Because Jinder Mahal beat him after the Sin Brothers. This was actually their debut when the Sin Brothers avoided Sami Zayn from winning that match. So he's lost so many opportunities. And it's like, how much more opportunities is he going to lose? He was already basically doing the exact same thing on Monday Night Raw. And you just start to wonder how much more can Sami take. So it's just going to be interesting to see how they built this and what they're going to do with Sami Zayn's character. You know, is this really going to be the heel turn that everybody wanted and needed? Or is this just going to be a letdown where they had him turn heel, but then they still don't do anything with him? I mean, you've got to capitalize on this. This is one of the problems that WWE has today. When they turn someone babyface, when they turn someone heel, a lot of times they don't know how to capitalize on that. And that's why it fails and really just kills everybody's momentum. But for this one particularly, this is the opportunity where they can do something. This is the opportunity they can take this, what they just did with Sami Zayn, and actually make it into something. It's going to be quite interesting. I think him and Kevin can actually make a monster team. Not to say that Kevin would need to team up with Sami Zayn, but I think the tag team division himself would need that boost simply because there's not a lot of teams since they decided to break up so many teams this year. and some of them didn't even go to the main roster when they broke up, like DIY, the fact that they didn't even come to the main roster when they broke up. But there's been so many team breakups this year that it's like, it's well needed for it to be some spice in the tag team division. I mean, we kind of already seen a little bit of it, but it's like, we just need to see more of that. So, I don't think Kevin should go anywhere. Definitely Sami Zayn shouldn't go anywhere. They should both remain on SmackDown Live. That's really what the future, that's really what everybody cared the most about, other than the amazing feud between the New Day and the Usos that eventually is coming to an end. But it is just amazing how these guys continue to build and build with their feud. But, you know, absolutely amazing. I think this was needed. I think this was needed for Sami Zayn's character because there was just nothing else for him. I mean, there comes a time where if you play the same role so much, it's like you start to wonder, you know, how much more do they have for you? And for Sami, it was like, it just got to a point where you could just basically see that they just had nothing else for him. And I mean, I felt bad for him. I really did. So, you know, and that just comes with the creative writers and the stuff that they do and the creative team, that they're not, it's just sad some of the booking that they do for these guys. But I'm really hoping that this is not a failure, this is not a disappointment. We've seen how when some guys turn heel, it doesn't do them any favors. I quite frankly think Sami will probably get massive, you know, popularity either way, being a face or a heel. He's just one of those type of characters. It's sad because he was actually a really good baby face, and he could have actually won some gold. You know, if they weren't going to give him a big one, obviously, he could have won some mid-card championships, but they just would not give it to him. Kevin has achieved way more than he has within the last year or so that he's been on the main roster. I mean, it's just sad. Kevin has achieved so much in just 2 years of being on the main roster. Sami technically first came to Monday Night Raw 2 years ago, but he didn't officially join the main roster until last year. He hasn't won a single thing. So it's like, you know, Kevin has had way more success than Sami has. Kevin is a 3-time United States champion. He's a 2-time Intercontinental champion. And he's even a former Universal, the second Universal champion. So it's going to be interesting to see what they can do with Sami Zayn's character. I would hope they build it from here. I would hope that they really do something with him that we could all appreciate and be glad of. And hopefully, like I said before, this is not a failure. Hopefully this is going to help Sami Zayn build and build and build, because Kevin's already achieved basically almost nearly done it all at this point. The only thing he has not won is the tag team championships, but he basically won every title there is to win right now in WWE within the 2 years he's been here. The fact he's won it in the times that he's won it just shows you how much he's, you know, achieved within the 2 years he's been in the company. Not to say he won alone, but it just shows you, you know, how much he's achieving. Now it's Sami Zayn's turn to do the same. So if they're going to put a title on Sami Zayn, if they don't want it to be a mid-card title, they can at least give him the tag team championship with Kevin. I think these guys can probably dominate the tag team division. Even though the babyface heel isn't really satisfied on either side of the overall, but definitely on SmackDown Live, I think they could really do something with the tag team. We'll see. Personally, sadly, I don't think they will make them a tag team simply because they won't. Because they would feel that it's not really do Kevin any favors. But it's like, I just think he should stay on SmackDown Live. There's no reason for him to go back to Monday Night Raw. I mean, with the thing that they're doing with the show now, there's just no reason at all he should go back to Monday Night Raw. He's basically done everything on Monday Night Raw. I don't think he should go back. But that remains to be seen. So, that's basically this video, guys. I wasn't trying to make it too long because in about 30 minutes or so, I'll be getting ready for school. So, Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys subscribe, make sure you do that. Thumbs up, whatever. Signing off is Ray Master Flex, so like.